If you wanna be my lover, you gotta go with my friends. Make it last forever. Friendship. What is this? A new Playmobil Ghostbusters box set? Hey everybody, Jason here of GhostbustersNews.com, and as always, Ghostbusters News right here on YouTube, and I'm pretty pumped about this thing. As you saw in the intro video, I was at my local Walmart, and I just kind of stumbled across this brand new Playmobil Ghostbusters set. Like, I knew it existed, like it was revealed like earlier this year or late last year, but, you know, COVID hit, and I didn't actually hear anything at all about it, so I thought maybe it was like on the back burner, and we wouldn't actually see it until like maybe, you know, next year for like Ghostbusters Afterlife, but it's here. It's here now. I'm excited, and I want to tear into it and, you know, build it and show it off to you guys. So once again, that's what we're going to be doing here on the Ghostbusters News YouTube channel. Alright, so the official name of this box set is the Playmobil Ghostbusters Play Box, and as you can see, it includes previous release figures of Dr. Peter Venkman and Slimer, but the whole selling point of this set is the actual Play Box, which looks like a miniature scaled-down version of the Ghostbusters Firehouse. Now let's turn it around right quick here. We're actually going to have a bit of a checklist on the back of here of everything that's included. Once again, the Play Box itself, which looks like a miniature firehouse, and a ton of items. The vast majority we've already seen released with the full-scale Ghostbusters Firehouse. Now I can't wait, let's go ahead and crack this thing open. Alright, now that we got everything unboxed here, first and foremost, I want to take a look at the main body here, the main backing piece here of this Play Box. As you can see, there's no stickers, there's no decals on it, so I gotta know what to put where, so where are those instructions at? Taking a look inside the instruction manual, it looks like our very first step is going to be attaching this yellow piece to the top of that main base. First and foremost, we're going to actually have to attach this No Ghost sticker to it, which went on really, really clean. Looks really, really good there. And yeah, let's go ahead and grab the main base there, and it looks like it's just going to snap right into play. There it is. Looks really slick. Alright, so our next line of action is going to be attaching this back graphic piece here to the, well, this piece right here. As you can see, there's two like little pegs there. I'm actually going to take out these two like little circle hole areas, and wouldn't you know it, the pegs on that main back piece is going to go right through there, making a bit of a nice secure fit there. Yeah, I think we got it there. It looks really, really good there, giving me definitely a Ghostbusters Firehouse vibe. Alright, so after that, the next step is going to be attaching like the hinges to the left and right hand side so we can actually attach the locker doors to this Ghostbusters Play Box. So popping the first one in right here. Alright, and now we've got all four attached really nicely, nice and tight and secure there. Let's take a quick look at the instructions to see what is coming next there. And it looks like actually there is some adhesive to attach to the very bottom of like that box board kind of panel there to help secure it a little better. So here's the little kind of sticky tape full of adhesive, and all we got to do is just apply it down on the bottom base there. So there is one, and let's go ahead and attach the second one here, and I believe all we're gonna have to do is now peel these off, and it should leave a nice little sticky residue right at the bottom. Yeah, it did. Okay, cool. So yeah, so the stickiness actually stayed at the bottom there, as you can see. Let's go ahead and do the second one right here. Pull that up, and there it is. Just kind of rub around a little bit there. Make sure it's all nice and secure at the bottom there. All right, so after that, it looks like our next step is going to be attaching, well, kind of the actual backings to the left and right-hand side doors. And once again, we're going to be using the same like little circular like adhesive pieces right on those doors to kind of connect everything together there. So as you can see, there's a little circle on the top and the bottom. That is the adhesive already there. And let's go ahead and grab that backing piece and press it in, put a little bit of pressure there. Make sure it is nice, tight, and secure there so it's not gonna fall off or anything like that. And after that, let's go ahead and try and snap it right into place here. Put a little bit of pressure. There we go. And as you can see, it closes up. Looks just like, well, I call it a locker. Once again, it's a Playmobil Play Box. Now, the instructions are now telling me to start adding little details like the Ghostbusters fire alarm bell. So let me go ahead and tear into the bag here and pull out some of these goodies. All right, so let's go ahead and put together the Ghostbusters bell alarm. I got the main red piece, put the little silver piece, gray piece on top of it there, and I'm actually going to attach it with the red piece up because that's how the instructions are telling me to do it. That doesn't look right to me. Now in the open spot below the bell piece, I've got to actually attach like this little like silver kind of gray piece here. This is actually used to like hold equipment. So you know, if the Ghostbuster isn't using a piece of equipment, that can actually like fasten into there. Time to go ahead and do the other door here. As you can see, we already have the adhesive set in there, putting the backing on there. Once again, rubbing inwards there to make sure we have a nice secure fit. Now, I didn't actually think about this before, but having like these little pieces here on those sides make it so you can't actually close the doors properly. So if you do want to close them, you actually have to remove those pieces. Now, another thing I want to note here is, once again, I put this alarm bell on here exactly how the instructions told me to. You can see it right there, the red part, you know, up on the top part of it there, the actual silver piece at the bottom. Now, what's interesting is taking a look on the actual box art here, you can see it's the other way around. And that to me is how it should be. All right, so I fixed the alarm bell. I'm kind of wondering why they don't actually want you to have it like this. That seems a little weird to me. That's why they don't want you to have it like that. Makes sense. Okay. So yeah, the pressure of the door will actually knock the alarm off if you have it the proper way. So we actually have to put it upside down, I guess. So next, we are going to be putting together the containment unit. I'm actually pretty pumped about this because the containment unit in this Playbox set is actually a bit different than the containment unit we saw in the actual Firehouse release. Let's go ahead and attach the handle here to the main containment unit door. What's actually really cool about this, you can actually kind of move the handle up and down there, much like it was moved in the original film. Also, it does come with decals and stickers. So give me a second here and let me pimp this containment unit right out. Stickers really, really make this thing pop, I will say. Now, after that, there is like a little kind of silver handle here that we can attach on the right-hand side here. Let's see if we can kind of work it in. There we go. And the handle itself can be moved up, can be moved down there as well. So you can make sure the light is green and the trap is most certainly clean. From there, let's go ahead and attach the main door there. And as you can see, the door itself, once attached, can both open and close, and you can put your ghost trap inside. All right, so the instructions are telling me to put a little black connector piece right in there. And then after that, let's go ahead and slide the containment unit into its new home. Once again, I love the look of this containment unit. Looks so good. I think I actually like this containment better than the one that came with the actual full-blown Playmobil Firehouse. And the last little step to get this containment unit installed in this miniature Ghostbusters Playmobil Firehouse Playbox, whatever you want to call it, is just attaching this little silver wire from that little connector piece we just installed into the top of the Ghostbusters containment unit. So I actually decided to move the containment unit down just a hair there. And that's actually the really cool thing about these two doors. You can actually attach the left and right hand side items anywhere you want, as high or as low. And right here, we're about to attach this little piece, which is pretty much like a little like weapons rack where you can put like all the Ghostbusters gear on. And I'm gonna dress it up just like it is in the instruction manual. Let's kind of attach it near the middle there, and let's just start once again kind of dressing it up here with all the additional little pieces that the set comes with. And actually, you know what, I think we're pretty much done here when it comes to the main build of the actual play box. So give me a second, let me build the Slimer, the Peter, and all the equipment here, and I'll finish off building this Ghostbusters Playmobil set. All right, now we've got everything set up here. Now let's take a quick look at the figures that come in the package here. Both of these figures are the exact same we've seen previously released like in other sets. Venkman there, of course, with the slime flight suit. I wish we could eventually get a clean Venkman, but that's not in the cards with this set. But still though, a really fun, absolutely adorable minifigure here, and all the details from the previous set come over to this set here, including all those like little details on the proton pack, on the wand, on the radio, and of course the PKE meter, which as you can see, I have got Slimer holding here. And once again, the Slimer figure, great, great minifigure. He's got those disgusting rolls, a Slimer fat there. And of course, turning around to the back, we have got as good of a Slimer booty as you're gonna get in a kid's toy line. And if all the gear I've already talked about isn't enough, of course, yes, we do have a ghost trap. Now let's switch our focus to the star of the show here, which is the actual play box. And I love the graphic being used on the back there. Looks great. Also the pieces it comes with. We got the desk, we got the phone, we got the chair on top of that as well. Taking a look over on the left hand side, we have got that wonderful, wonderful containment unit. Like I said beforehand, I like this containment unit more than the one that actually came with the full-blown Playmobil Ghostbusters Firehouse. And of course, this is fully functional, meaning that Peter, as you can see right here, he's loading it up with a ghost trap. Now on the right-hand side here, we've got that kind of like equipment tray where we kind of have like a bit of a holster up top there for the proton packs. And on the right-hand side, we've got a flashlight, which is brand new to the Playmobil Ghostbuster set. I know it's been in other Playmobil sets though in the past. We've also got a camcorder there on a tripod, which I loved in the actual Firehouse set. And also, we did get a fire extinguisher, which does attach itself to the actual frame. And being that this is a play box, the whole gimmick with this playset is it also doubles as a play box, as a carrying case. As you can see right here, everything fits inside. Now, my honest opinion, I think this set is just pure fun, and this is a great starting off point for somebody looking to get into the Playmobil Ghostbusters line, or a great additional piece there if you've already collected all the Ghostbusters Playmobil items up to this point. I mean, look how fun this shot is of it. But that's not all, because this set also does come with green slime here, so you can totally customize your Playmobil Ghostbusters play box, slime it all up, as you can see right there. I love the look of this thing, and I cannot recommend this set any higher. If you see it out in the wild, you get it, you won't regret it. So that does it for our look today at the Ghostbusters play box from Playmobil. If you'd like to pick one up, we've got some links down below in the description where you can actually buy yours today. And before I cap off today's video, a reminder there, be sure to subscribe to Ghostbusters News right here on YouTube to stay up to date with all the Ghostbusters News happenings, as well as also if you'd like to help support Ghostbusters News, we do have a Patreon page. Link to that can be found right below in the description. Signing up to it gets you exclusive content, and at the same time, you also help out Ghostbusters News, so it's like all win-win, guys. So if you guys don't mind, I'm probably gonna go and play with this Ghostbusters Playmobil set for the next hour or two, and I'll see everybody right back here next time, Ghostbusters News, right here on YouTube.